let's return to one of those enduring topics. We've covered it a few times in these sessions in the past. It sort of rumbles on, though, and that's 4.25 electric van derogation. Paul, come back to you, because I know it remains a hot topic amongst your membership. What's the latest?
I think Matt and Lorna will agree, maybe Duncan as well. It's all still a mess. And particularly with Matt and Lorna being, and me being a part of the three that are running the AFP, we are regularly, this is probably issue number one for our members. And it just is bonkers that we just can't seem to get this sorted out between everybody. So at the moment, as most people are aware, so basically once you're over 3.5 ton van, you're into O license and you're into a level of legislation in terms of tacos and everything else. Obviously, there's OZEV of kindly, because a 3.5 ton e-van goes overweight to 4.25, up to 4.25 tons because of the weight of the battery. OZEV have kindly agreed that there's a level of dispensation, which means that you don't need to do particular things. The downside is between OZEV and the DVSA, neither are aligned. So some things are effectively removed, but from a DVSA perspective, pretty much, you know, it's still pretty much a functioning bigger van and it needs a taco, et cetera, et cetera. So we've been liaising with OZEV, DVSA. I've spent a bit of time with OZEV, and if I'm honest, Lorna's been the peacemaker between me and OZEV to try and make sure I haven't lost it. But those guys are receptive. They just don't, I think they understand the issue, but it's really impacting a lot of fleets at the moment. So at the moment, the big issues are taco or not. We've taken some guidance from Ford and Stellantis and been working quite well with those guys, and also discussed the issue with Mercedes as well, who tend to be the three bigger manufacturers just trying to sort the issue out. We've produced some guidance for members, as a members bulletin, about the best practice way of dealing with the vehicles. For Ford vehicles, you should be ideally deselecting the taco on order, as long as the vehicles are always going to be doing less than 100k from base as well. So if you're over 100k from base, you're going to need a taco. Stellantis, we're still working through some of their ordering processes to make sure we've got best practice in place for Stellantis, and we'll do the same for Mercedes as well. It's just a really challenging topic because, from our perspective, and Duncan's mentioned this on some webinars, it's just a van. It should be categorized as a van. There's no reason why it should not be a van. But with the current rules, particularly via the DVSA, there are still some responsibilities for fleet operators. And some of our members don't want to carry an O license, don't want vehicles with tacos, just because of the weight of the batteries pushing it into that territory. So it's a real minefield at the moment. So if anyone on the webinar wants some advice, please reach out to us, and we'll provide advice directly. A lot of our bigger members are really struggling with it as well. You know, the supermarkets, obviously, with their delivery trucks, DPD, Speedy, a lot of the guys are really struggling with this. And of course, the rules as well, Northern Ireland and cross-border, are different as well. So it's a really complicated topic, I'm afraid.
Duncan, Paul's teed you up there. It's just a van.
I'm going to go Matt on everybody. It just frustrates the hell out of me. You know, if I was a manufacturer, why would I want to sell this size van into the UK market right now? I'd just give up, quite frankly. And all the other legislation's carrying on. So we've got, you know, 10% EV next year now. But there's a whole segment of this market we can't actually convert to EV because it's just complicated and the rules have changed so much and there's no simplicity about it. That's then putting even more pressure on the small mid-size van. We're gonna have to sell maybe 13, 14% EVs in the small mid-size van to compensate for this bit of the market's not ready. And you just get back to the basics. It's a van, okay? The only reason the derogation was given in the first place is just because of the weight of the batteries. Nothing else changed. And I think that simplicity needs to win through. I can see manufacturers just saying, you know what, I won't bother selling this size van to the UK market and just literally pull out of the production slots. And just focus on, you know, building left-hand drive ones rather than right-hand drive ones. It's something that I think the association's on to, but we need to get the right people to actually just listen.
Make
the change.
Matt, your thoughts? And so Rob Anderson's asked whether the derogation is just on the vehicle weight or does it include towing? I think I've lost Oh, am I back?
Yeah, Steve. Yeah,
yeah. I think I suddenly lost everyone then. So, yeah, Matt, the Robert Anson's asking whether the 4.25 derogation is just on the vehicle weight or does it include towing as well? And I think you did pick up one of the questions or one of the points asked around residual values as well.
Yeah, I think, the 4.25 on the vehicle weight, that's where it starts from. You know, this was put in place to, like Paul said, to compensate for the weight of the batteries. And I think you've got to look at, ultimately, going back to Duncan's point, we are overcomplicating this process. It is just a van. The whole principle was, it's a 3.5-ton van, but we've given an allowance up to 4.25 because of the weight of the batteries. All the other complications that have been put in there, all the TACO rules, all the annual MOTs, all the other bits and pieces are just clouding the whole issue. And what we're seeing from the AFP members, there are a lot of people are trying to cancel orders at the minute because they don't know what they're doing. The manufacturers aren't absolutely clear what they're doing. And like Paul mentioned, you can specify that you don't want to TACO if you're going to be with your 100 kilometres. But Daniel said in the chat, how is that going to affect your resale? You know, someone's going to have to pay £800-900 to put a TACO in that truck, in that van, if they're going to want to take it out that 100 at the end of it. So it seems to have been too many people having too much input and nobody aligned on the process. And everybody's got their own view and thoughts. I think whenever you get into that sort of position, you're always going to end up with a situation where nobody knows what the actual answer is. And it's the operators that are going to suffer at the end. And that's what's happening and that's what we're seeing from the members. And until they get aligned and until we can get a definitive on this and we can go back to the core principle, which is it is just a van. It's a slightly heavier van because it's got batteries, but it's still a van. It still sits under the same standard rules as a normal long wheelbase transit, then we're going to continue with these issues.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Paul.
Just to add as well, you know, we are still, you know, fighting a good fight with the DFT at the moment. They have asked for some information from us in the BVRLA, which we duly provided, which was actually a bit bizarre, I thought, about the safety elements. So are the 4.25 ton vans having a worse safety record than the 3.5 brethren? And of course, my response was, don't be so stupid, it's the same bloody van. But the reality is we've gone off and provided that evidence to the DFT for them to have another look at it as well. And the other thing to point out as well is if you do end up having a TACO on the van, but because of the requirement, the requirement for a 12-month service, if you're not calibrating that TACO, it will fail on 12-month service as well. So just for everybody to be aware on the that's viewing that, again, if you do put a TACO in, just be aware that you need to calibrate it as well to be careful with everything. And again, just if you want any advice, come to us and we can help.